Hey guys. Okay, I got some more stuff the past 2 weeks. Updates and things I got. Stuff I've been doing with Christ. So I'm going to start off with the lessons because they're important. And he said, I had a dream. Woke up from a dream. I'm laying there in bed. He said, you got to let go of your burdens. I'm like, what are my burdens? He says, well, you let go of your burdens, they don't bother you anymore. Then you can get or create new stuff in your life. So if something's keeping you down, something's making you miserable every day, like work, you either got to change your job or deal with it. It's a burden and it's holding you back. He goes, if you don't do that, then you get stuck in the grind. And whatever the burden is, problems in your head, if you hang on to it and you keep repeating it over and over and over in a circle, cycle, it grinds you down. It takes your, basically, you get sick. You get cancer and tumors. You start to go slowly insane because you're not letting the creator, creation, or life of force do what it's supposed to do, which is make new stuff for you. And so he said, let go of your burdens, no matter whatever you do. And he goes, you can compromise for so long, but then it's just, you're just compromising the burden. But you gotta let go of the burden, be it whatever it is, your parents, your job. You owe drug dealers money. You gotta figure it out and let it go and do it. So that was one. Then he showed me. He goes, the way the life force works is this, and he goes, you'll notice it over time. Like old people will notice it. Older people will notice it because they've been through it longest. And he goes, it's like this. He goes, the life force goes like this. You'll have, he gave me like a graph, but he used his finger. And he goes, it'll be like this. He goes, 1 month it'll be going, everything will be working out great for you, and everything, and all of a sudden it goes down, and everything will be working against you. For you, and against you. For you, and against you. Month after month. But it's not set by months. It's set by time or whatever, the creator. He goes, everybody goes through this. Everything's working out good, more or less, and then everything's working out bad. And all you got to do is shift and adapt to it. So, and it shows you, it keeps showing you all your problems in your life. It keeps creating new stuff. And he goes, if you want to ride the wave of goods and bads, don't look at them as goods and bads. Look at them as choices, like not choices, let's say adaptation to your life with creation. So he goes, when everything's working out good for you, grab it all, grab it, everything you can, and love it, and then let it go. But you got the stuff, I mean, be it winning the lottery, getting a girlfriend, getting a boyfriend, getting a new car, everything's working good for you, you're feeling great, and all of a sudden it turns. One day you wake up and everything's shit. You feel like crap and everything works against you. He goes, and then times, you gotta, I don't know. Anyway, he didn't tell me what you gotta do. He just let it ride it out. Don't fight it. And he goes, you don't fight that stuff. When everything's going bad against you, it's either because you got burdens you haven't let go of, and it's showing you your burdens. That's what it's doing. When everything's going bad, and it's hitting you, 1, 2, 3, you know, 3, 3, 3, things happen in threes. When everything's going bad, just let it ride past, acknowledge it, let it ride past, don't get all upset and frustrated, just understand this is just the life force flowing through you, showing you your burdens, which you got to let go of. Once you let go of them, the creator, when it's hitting you with burdens, it goes through, you don't have no burdens. New things are created in your life for you when it takes the turn again. It brings in new stuff. Or whatever, you know what I'm saying? Up or down. He goes, that's what the burden is, and that's why things will work out for you really great for a month or so, and all of a sudden it turns to crap, and you're just crap. He goes, just let it ride it out in your reality. He goes, that's what you got to learn, and that's all basically instinctual. You can feel it throughout your life, and that's why older people can identify it a lot faster. But he goes, once you identify your burdens, then you can deal with them and let them go. And what that life, the good and the bad in your life, as it fluctuates, it's showing you and pointing things out to you in your head that you got to deal with. Because you notice how your job will be shit 1 month and everything's bad and you can't deal with it, and you can't stand it, and you just like more or less want to off yourself or quit or fucking whatever. Right? Been through it, I know it. And also the next, everything's okay, you're still working on your job, but everything's a lot different, it's a lot finer, you can deal with it, you can flow with it, you know, everything's fine. That's it, it's showing you your burden. And a burden is a circle. When you run around in your life in a circle, over and over and over, doing the same fucking redundant thing, that's not good. Once you get into a cycle, that's not good. Because then it becomes a burden. And it grinds you and grinds you and grinds you and grinds you and grinds your life. And next thing you know, you get cancer, you get sick, you get tumors, you're getting addicted to drugs to deal with pain or whatever. This is over years, but this is how it happens. So, there you go. And he said, give your burdens to Christ. He goes, so, when you meditate, he says, bring in Christ. He goes, bring in Christ consciousness. That'll help. Then, ask Christ to take your burdens, help you through your burdens. He'll come in to give you dreams and everything, help you deal with your burdens. But you got to acknowledge you got a burden. And you got to acknowledge, you got to let it go and make changes in your life. And then do that. And he'll help you through it. Some people just can't do it. They just suck at it. And I know I do. Some burdens, I can't deal with them. So I need Christ to put me in that position to run me through them. And lesson dreams and stuff like that. Okay? So that was pretty cool, because like I was laying there sleeping, and she's talking to me about burdens and the cycles of grind, and when you're caught in a grinding cycle over and over and over and over and over again, the same fucking thing happens to you. It's called a cycle. You gotta make changes and let go of your burden to break the cycle. And once you do that, you break the cycle, the Creator can come in and create new things for you. And if you understand it all up here, and you live it in consciously, not spiritually, in your life, well then, it's a lot easier. The water just flows through you. The life force, right? The Creator can create things. But you can't create things when you're in a grind, in a box. Right? So you gotta let it go. So, that was the one big thing he showed me. That was really cool. Then, I got to thinking about my life when I'm dead. I got to thinking about St. Lucia and what I'm going to be doing. And I gotta get something going, man. I got to get something going, because I'm going to be going there. So, what I'm doing is creating for the future. And I go, well, I'm into all this exploration and outdoor stuff, right? And I go, why don't I make some kayaks, right? Start making kayaks. And I can rent them out to people that go on expeditions and or just day trips, whatever. You know, you get a bunch of like 20, 30 kayaks, canoes, outdoor gear, and start a business where you rent it out to people. And they want to go have fun for the day. Or go away for a month and go kayaking out in the woods, out in the mountains somewhere. And I go, that's cool. And then there's things I want to do. So I wanted a truck where I could do like my research and stuff, like photography, where I can go. And so I made this truck. I went on the internet, found a truck I like that would work great for what I want to do. And what I want to do is like go off-road, beaches, mountains, rivers, all that stuff way out in the middle of nowhere. And found my truck. And what I did was, I took the truck and I made it. I converted, well, it's pretty much the same as what I'm seeing. I created the truck. Well, it was over a week it took me to create the truck in the illusion. I put in computers, and it's got a great big thermal imaging camera on it, which I can control from the inside. So I'm out looking for Bigfoot, which I'm gonna do, I don't care. Be it whatever, polar bears, Bigfoot. Which brings me up to the next thing. So I converted, I got three computers. I got one computer for the infrared around the truck, so when Bigfoot comes and smashes on the truck, I can film it. And then, or whatever the fuck, UFOs, aliens, Bigfoot, whatever they got in spirit world, I'm gonna film it, just because I got nothing to do. So, I got the infrared around the truck, I got thermal imager built into the truck. It's a big one, it's a big ass FLIR, like the helicopter's got. And then I got, all this shit's free, I just created, right? And if I can't, I learned something else how to create. But I'll tell you that later. So I got this truck, I'm going to show it to you in a minute. And I put in thermal imaging computer, infrared computer. I got another computer behind me for a video, cameras and that. You can download the video, put it on your hard drive or whatever. And then I got a laptop for the same thing, basically. So I got three big-ass giant computers that are built into the wall on a swing arm. You take them out, swing them around, left or right around you. Then I need communications because my family's going to be going, or other researchers with me, we're going to be going, my friends, and we need communications. So I went online, looked for ham radio or CB radios to communicate with when I'm fucking 2,000 miles out in the middle of nowhere, which is what I want to do. Like, fucking Pluto ain't far enough, as far as I'm concerned. But I need communications now. I need communications for people that are out in the field, and I can talk to them, or we can talk to each other throughout the woods, right? So I found these walkie-talkies, but they're ham radio walkie-talkies, and they're ham radio. And they got all the functions on them, and I'm like, shit, that's cool. So I made a couple of those and kept them. Then Christ got to playing with it. He freaked out. He wanted one, so I made two more for me. So Christ has got a pair, and I got a pair. And we're all cool. Then I thought, well, fuck. And I put them in the truck, right? On where the computers are on the truck. And I go, well, fuck. You know, I need, I got real ham radio. And I need CB radio. And I need emergency frequencies. I need all that different kinds of radios, right? And I'm like, well, this could be my radio where I can put all my radios and stuff. I'm like, cool. So, then, I looked online, found this ham radio, and I'll show you, and I couldn't make it. It was just too much. Remember how I had a hard time making the amplifier, the Marshall Stack amplifier? Had a hard time, still don't work, by the way. I had a hard time making it. Well, I'm sitting there, and all of a sudden, Mom started screaming, my inner light, she started screaming. She goes, I'll make one for you. I'm like, really? So I shit myself. I'm like, holy fuck. And so she started making it. What she did was she was breaching it out of my heart. Like, she was creating it in me and breaching it out. And this started last year, me breaching. I didn't think, you know, this ain't gonna work. And I can't create it. How's she? And this damn thing's got like 1,000 buttons and dials and things on it, this ham radio. She creates it. She created that, come out of my chest. The speakers came out of it. The microphone came out. Wires came out. Wires that you can hook it up to the computer and run it from the computer. They all came out. And two instruction manuals. Yeah, three actually. Three different ones. Now what happened was the instruction manual, the first one she got was for discs. Disc drive manual. They didn't work with a ship. The next one was my little drive that you plug in the back as a USB drive. That came out with the instruction manuals on it and how to work it. I told Chris how to, he didn't know what to do with it. I'm like, plug it in the back of the computer. You'll find a slot in the back of the computer, stick it in there, and all of a sudden, the instruction manual will come up on the screen. Then scroll through it and read it. And he's like, he spent like 2 hours trying to figure out what this thing was. Until he asked me. And I was awake, so I couldn't talk to him. But then, just in case, I asked Mom to make me a book instruction manual. And she breached a book. So I gave it to Grace, and I go, here's your instruction. No, Grace is freaking out. They took me and isolated me when I started breaching. So no one else could see it, right, in the secret little room. This is what they do, because they don't want the general public to see me breaching important stuff, because it creates a big shitstorm throughout the city. When people, it spreads. One person sees it, Richard's creating a ham radio out of his heart. Boom! It goes nuts, right? So they isolated me from it. And so I created the ham radio, and I was going to keep it, but I gave it to Christ. Christ, a half a day goes by after he got this thing. He got it working. A day goes by. I go to sleep at night, like midnight or something, and Christ is there. He's freaking out. The kids are freaking out. Everybody's screaming and yelling, and he's talking to people all over the world. And he kept saying, it's in the illusion. It's in the illusion. I go, what do you mean? And he goes, well, he goes, I'm in St. Lucian, right? And I go, yeah. And he goes, I'm talking to people all over the world, but in the illusion. And so dead people. And he goes, well, both. And I go, what do you mean, both? And he goes, well, souls can talk, right? Right? Like my soul talks. And he goes, well, other people's souls talk. So soul is basically in the illusion. Okay? Now, reality is illusion too, but there's different illusions, I guess. So there's a reality, but he's in St. Lucian, which is another reality like this, like we're in. But as soon as you cross over into sleep, you're in the illusion, be it in St. Lucian with Christ or here on earth. When you cross over and go to sleep and you're creating and you're paying attention and you're sleeping and you're dreaming and you're having fun, you're creating in the illusion. Now go conscious. We are consciously awake in the illusion. Now you're in illusion. He goes, well, there's dead people, and then there's you that go into the illusion. And there's people all over the world, dead, at all levels, in the illusion, that are playing with their ham radios. Christ started talking to people in Sydney and Chile and fucking Nicaragua and all this. He was freaking out. And they're all Christians. He goes, most of them were Christians. And he started... help, people started asking him, I'm Jesus Christ from St. Lucia. And people were, he was inundated by people asking him questions, how to heal and take care and leave. So he spent a whole half a day helping people. And he told me, and I go, well, I guess it's yours. So I gave him the shortwave radio, so now he can help people, other spirits, in the illusion, get to where they want to go. You know? Whatever. So I'm out of ham radio. Unbelievable. I'll show you to you right now. You gotta see this thing, man. It's fucking sick. So I got the truck. That's my truck. Now, you see, I don't know if this is a thermal imager, but it is in my world. And I gave it a repaint. I've got all the gear on it, on the top and on the sides. Gave it a repaint. I put the roll bars down the sides. I got a camera here on the back and front for infrared, and inside I got the 1 and 2 computers. Near side I got another computer, and here along this part is where I got my radio set up, and basically it's all wheel drive and it works. Christ flipped out when he turned the key and started driving it. It works in St. Lucian, and I created it. So, he went through it and told me how to tighten stuff up. The steering was loose, and I tightened that steering up, which is a trip. That's a trip to do. I gave it a repaint. It's mango with black trim. All the black and mango. I love that color. And
See, this is just boring. Boring color. So I braided it up, shined it up, and gave it some bling. But other than that, it's got like, I put all the lights on top. I put the roll bar, the cow catchers on the front, you know, for the trees and stuff. So I got it all decked out and ready to go. I'm going to put the kayaks on top. Now, I got my research vehicle, right? So, let me just go here. I'm going to show you. So that's my vehicle I got for doing, like, technical. That's a tech truck. I'm calling it the tech truck. Then, let me see here if I can find it. I want to find the, whatchamacallit for you guys. The radio. There. Okay, there it is. It's a Kenwood blah, 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 blah radio. Look at this thing. Ham radio. That's the one Chris is using. And I got two walkie-talkies. They're going to be... I don't think I can get a new one, but Mom created that, and it works. Jesus. He flipped out when he's playing with it. He don't know how to work all these buttons and everything, but he's got the instruction manual, and he can play with it, and he's got other researchers. The microphone and the speakers came out. They worked. Everything's working. And basically, he's talking to everybody around the whole world in the illusion. How cool is that? Okay, so with that, I got, that's the one truck. Now, my old truck, I'm going to get it converted into, and the reason I'm telling you all this is because I am. Okay, that's the one from The Walking Dead, and I made that one, but see, it's really enclosed. It's not really good for people. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut it here, and I'm going to put on a new back, right? So it'll be more like a camper type thing. So that one I'm making, and I'm making a new one. I got to convert that one, and I'm making another one, and it's going to be pretty much like this, like that. And so people, and plus I got a Humvee. I made a Humvee too. So people could take, that's like an apartment on this truck for expedition. So you get your researchers, and you put them in the tech truck. They're researching. Then you get this truck. And this is where they live, in the truck. And the other truck and the Humvee, depending on what. But the reason I'm making all these is because when I'm not using them, I'm renting them out for $1,000 a week. And if anything breaks, there's no life insurance. There's none of that shit. And anything breaks, I fix it. Will it. Create it. Fix it. There's no life insurance. There's no bullshit. There's no 1,400... laws. You don't need a lawyer to run your business. None of that stuff. Because it's the spirit world, right? So I get these trucks. People get to drive out in the mountains for 2 weeks with their kids, live in this thing, and have a good time. They rent it out. Now, the tech truck is more or less for me, but if a bunch of scientists want to use the tech truck to go off and study stuff or do research in St. Lucian, well, I call it St. Lucian, but it's Christ's plane of existence, whatever. They can rent it out, take it, and rent. They can rent these trucks, the ones you live in, because it's basically an apartment, right? So I'm going to make another one of these, but smaller, the apartment ones. I'm going to make a smaller one, plus the huge one here, plus my tech truck. I'm using that for me. And I have to convert the Fear of the Walking Dead truck, call it whatever, because it's basically what it looks like on the show. I never knew I could convert it. I mean, I knew, but it's a lot of time to do it. So I'm going to do that. Then I made kayaks. They can take them on the trip, rent them, take them on the trip. So when I get there, I'll have my whole business, all the stuff ready to go. Price is already figuring it out. He goes, I think that's going to be too much to rent out.
I've been checking the deals and the facts and how much everything goes. And I go, well, look, don't even worry about it. We'll just work it. And he goes, I go, people, kids, and that are going to need this. And then when I got done that, I was talking to him about that. And I built the truck. I had a dream. I told you, this is a dream. I'm in a dream. And I'm out in the woods. And I'm running down a dirt road in the woods, like deep in the woods. I'm running around. There's a grizzly bear chasing me and a couple other kids. And we run into this little community, and there's a tundra in front of us. I turn around, and I see little houses. I run over to the houses. And as I'm coming to the houses, the little huts, house huts, there's kids running around, and this polar bear came walking out between the two huts. And everybody freaked out, sounded the alarm. This little old lady came out, little Inuit lady, came out with a hatchet and got its attention and then smashed it with the blunt end of the hatchet and killed it right here in the forehead. I'm like, holy shit. So I ran over there and I woke up. When I'm talking with the grandma, I'm talking with the grandma and there's a dead polar bear. And I woke up. And as soon as I realized what happened in the dream, I skinned the fucking polar bear in like 20 seconds. Get it, took the fur off it. Okay, I know it sounds great, but it's not a real fucking bear. It's just it is in a sense, but it ain't. So I skinned it and I took it back and I gave it to the kids. I go, take this right. And then Grace got it. He goes, can I have this? And I'm like, yeah, you can take it. I don't fucking skin it, a polar bear. But anything in my dreams, I grab it, man. Just grab it, give it to me, ninja, because it's cool. And so Grace, he got all flipped out. He came down, threw me into this dream, because I was still in the dream while I'm awake, laying in bed. He came in the dream. He was floored. He couldn't believe it. Found out I was in the Arctic, somewhere up in Nunavut, and he started filming me. He filmed the bear. He filmed the Inuit people. He filmed them all. Now I got video of me from my dream. When I die, I can go to that Christ, sit there and watch the videos that he made of me in the illusion where people live, different places. And I go, this is where I'm taking my truck, and I'm gonna drive the beach for 1,000 miles. And he goes, that's why you build the truck. And I go, you goddamn right. And that Bigfoot, and I go, he goes, I saw like 4 grizzly bears and this polar bear, which lady killed the grizzly bears. I'm like, Jesus Christ. With that camera you got right now, I could make $100,000 just taking pictures of bears. That's what I want to do. That's what I am. I'm a photographer. Nature photographer. And the dream showed me, yeah, Rich, there's nature. And it's just as vicious as it is there. Did you get it? Awesome stuff, man. So, there you go. Later, guys.